Hello, today I shall discuss about the common emitter characteristics. Here this one it is a PNP transistor and the directions of the currents which are flowing at the three terminals of the transistors, that is collector current, emitter current and base currents. Since this one it is a PNP transistor, so that the current at the emitter, it is towards the emitters, and the base current and the collector currents are away from the emitters. Okay, here whatever the biasing voltages which you have applied at the base emitter and at the collector and base terminals, here the for the active region of operation, for that one emitter base junction is forward biased and collector base junction it is reverse biased. Now these are the characteristics which will be getting for the common emitter configuration of the transistors, that is the output characteristics. Here this one it is output voltage along the x-axis, and here it is the output current along the y-axis. And for the that is output voltage VCE and output current it is IC, and for the different values of the base current IB is equal to 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50 and 60. These are the different curves which you will be getting for the output characteristics. Now the common emitter configuration of a PNP transistor is as shown in the figures. Input characteristics are between the base current IB and VBE with VCE as a parameters. Input characteristics are between the input current and the input voltage, base current and IB and VBE with VCE as a parameters. Output characteristics are between IC and VCE. Output characteristics are between IC and VCE with IB as a parameters. Cutoff regions in the output characteristics with when IB is equal to 0, IC not equal to 0, as in the figures. When the base current IB is equal to 0, IC is not equal to 0. This one it is the output characteristics for the common emitter configurations. Here for common base configuration, here when input current is equal to 0, that is when emitter current is equal to 0, output current is equal to 0 in common base configurations. But here this region is known as the cutoff region of operation. Both the junctions are reverse biased. Here the common base configuration, here emitter current is equal to 0, for the collector current is equal to 0. But for the common emitter configuration, when the input current is equal to 0, output current is not equal to 0. Active region of operation. In this region, base current curves are equally spaced. In this region, base current curves are equally spaced and collector current IC increases with VCE in the active regions. Collector current IC increases with VCE in the active regions. This is to be noted here. Curves are not straight lines as in the common base configurations, because in the common base configurations the curves are totally, these are straight lines, and these will be, there will not be any increase in the slope of the curves with the increase in the output voltage in the common base configurations. But in the common emitter configuration, the base current curves are equally spaced and collector current IC increases with VC in the active regions. This is to be noted. That's why here in this output characteristics, you will be getting, these are the characteristics. There is an increase in the collector current. There is an increase in the collector current with VCE in the active region of operation, that here it is increasing. In this way it is increasing. But in the common base configurations, as you have studied here, the even though if we increase the output voltage, the output current it is remains constant. The output current it is totally remaining constant, even the output voltage it is increasing. That's why there will not be any effect of the output voltage on the output current in the active regions of operation of the common emitter, common base configurations. But in the common emitter configurations, it is the increasing in this way. There is a slight increase, so there is a slight slope of the base current curves in the active region of operations. So that here IC is in milliamperes and IB is in microamperes. This region is used in the amplification. Because here IB it is less, but there is a large increase in the collector currents. Saturation region of operation, the region in the output characteristics which is left side of VCE saturation is known as the saturation region of operation. The region in the output characteristics which is left side of VCE saturation is known as the saturation region. In this region, collector current IC increases exponentially with VCE up to VCE saturation. That is here. This region in the characteristics. Here, this voltage it is known as VCE saturation, and the collector current IC increases exponentially. This collector current IC increases exponentially with VCE. In the saturation region, and this IC increases with VCE up to VCE saturation. Collector current IC increases exponentially with VCE up to VCE saturation. This one it is the exponential increase in the collector current. Left side of VCE saturation is known as saturation region. In this region, collector current increases exponentially with VCE up to VCE saturation. Why collector current is not equal to 0, and the base current IB is equal to 0 amperes? Because here, this current it is the, when IB is equal to 0, IC is not equal to 0. Why this is in the common emitter configurations? You know that IC is equal to alpha IE plus ICO. IE is equal to IC plus IB, that also you know. IC is equal to alpha, so IC is equal to alpha IB upon 1 minus alpha ICB upon 1 minus. And IB is equal to 0 microamperes, IC is equal to ICEO. ICEO is equal to ICBO upon 1 minus alpha. The current gain beta of CE configuration is beta is equal to IC upon IB, IE is equal to IC plus beta. But alpha is equal to IC upon IE, so that IC upon alpha is equal to IC plus IC upon beta, so that the total equation is divided by IC. From that one, beta is equal to alpha upon 1 minus alpha. Adding 1 to both sides, we will be getting the alpha is equal to beta upon 1 plus beta. That is the relationship between the alpha and beta. Given that beta is equal to 180 and IC is equal to 2, find alpha I and IB. Alpha is equal to beta upon 1 plus beta is equal to 0. IC is equal to beta IB, IB is equal to IC upon beta IC, and I is equal to IC plus beta is 2.012 amperes. Because here IC is equal to, you know, alpha is equal to beta upon 1 plus beta, and IC is equal to beta IB, beta is equal to IB is equal to IC upon beta 0.012 milliamperes, C plus IB is equal to 0.012 milliamperes. Okay. Now, fixed bias configurations. For this one, it is a fixed bias configurations. The resistance RB, RC, and SVCC, and the coupling capacitors at the input and the outputs. For the DC analysis, coupling capacitors are open circuited so that analysis can be divided into input circuit and the output circuits. Because these two coupling capacitors, for the DC analysis, frequency is equal to 0, and the reactance of the capacitance is equal to 1 upon 2 pi fc, and the frequency is 0, reactance is equal to infinity, and the reactance is equal to infinity, that is the impedance is also equal to infinity, and the impedance offered by the capacitance is infinity, then current flowing through that capacitance is equal to 0, and the current is 0, it is open circuited. So that here input circuit and output circuit analysis. The analysis can be divided into input circuit and output circuit analysis. For the input circuit analysis, apply KVL at the input circuits. Here VCC, VCC, IB and VB. Apply KVL at the input circuits. Here, if we apply KVL at the input for this one, plus VCC, if we apply KVL in these circuits, plus VCC minus IBRB minus VB is equal to 0, IB is equal to VCC minus VB upon RB, IC is equal to beta. That is, if you know the IB, from that the IC can be determined, because it depends upon the beta of the transistors. So that IC is equal to beta IB, that is the one of the equations for one of the term for the operating point. Now, for the output circuit analysis, apply KVL to output circuits so that here these circuits, it is only first we have considered for the input circuits, and now we shall consider for the output circuits. Here it is RC, VCE, VCC, so that collector current IC, plus VCC minus ICRC minus VC is equal to 0, VC is equal to VCC minus ICRC. The operating point is, the operating point is IC, VCE. IC, apply KVL to input circuit so that IC is equal to beta IB. The operating point is IC, VCE. Because here, these are the operating points, because here first we have to consider VCE, IC. First it is x axis, VCE, IC, that is the operating point of the fixed bias configurations. How we shall analyze that circuits? First, that analysis is divided into input circuit, and then the analysis, it is divided into the output circuits. Okay. Now VC is equal to VC minus V, because there will not be any emitter resistance, so that due to which the emitter, it is directly connected to ground, emitter voltage is equal to 0. VCE is equal to VC, and similarly VB is equal to VB minus V. Since the emitter voltage, it is equal to 0, because there will not be any resistance in the emitter terminal, so that emitter is directly connected to ground, so that emitter is at the ground potentials. For that one, VB is equal to AB. Now, emitter stabilized bias circuits. For the emitter stabilized bias circuits, here it consists of the base resistance, a collector resistance, and a emitter resistance. A resistance at the base of the transistors, that is RB, it is that resistance, it is connected to plus VCC, and the another resistance at the collector it is another resistance at the collector it is the resistance RC. It is also connected to supply voltage, and here it is the emitter resistance. For the DC analysis, coupling capacitors at the input and the output are open circuited, because here the coupling capacitors are also present at the input and the output, so that the impedance offered by the capacitors in DC conditions is equal to infinity, so that the current it is high open circuit. These two are open circuit. Now the input circuit analysis. For the input circuit analysis, the circuit it is divided in these forms. Apply KVL to the circuits. For that, 1 plus VCC minus IBRB, the drop of voltage across this resistance RB. Here minus VBE, this one it is the minus VBE, and here it is the current flowing through that emitter resistance, it is in this direction. Minus IER, the drop of voltage across the resistance RE, the drop of voltage across the resistance RB, and the voltage between the base and the emitter, it is equal to VBE. So that from that one, IE is equal to IC plus IB, B is equal to beta IB plus IE is equal to beta plus 1 into bracket of IB. Plus VCC minus IBRB minus EB is minus beta plus 1 into IBRB. From that one, the base current IB is equal to VCC minus VB, VCC minus VB upon RB plus beta plus 1 into bracket of RA. This is the equation for the base current which is flowing at the base of the transistors. VCC minus VB upon RB plus beta plus 1 into bracket of RA. That is the equation for the base current which we shall determine. The only the difference between that the common base and this circuits is that for the common base configurations we have got the equation that the VCC minus VB upon RB, VCC minus VB upon RB, but for the emitter stabilized bias configurations the value of the base current is equal to VCC minus VB. Here the there we have got the only the RB, here we have got only RB, but here beta plus 1 into bracket of RE, beta plus 1 into bracket of RE, that is the sum of the factors which are used. Beta plus 1 into bracket of RE, that is the here it is the base current. Now IC is equal to beta IB, so that once for the common emitter configurations one base current is determined, from that to the collector current IC it can be determined. IC is equal to beta IB. The output circuit, that output circuit it consists of the resistances RC, resistance RC at the collector terminal, resistance RE at the emitter terminals, and voltage VCE, voltage between the collector and the emitters, and the supply voltage VCC. Apply KVL to the circuits. Plus VCC minus ICRC minus VCE minus IERE, it is equal to 0, because here plus VCC, here minus ICRC, minus VCE and minus IRE, it is equal to 0. VCE is equal to VCC minus ICRC minus IRE is equal to IC plus IB, IE is equal to beta IB plus IB. IE is equal to beta IB plus IB, and emitter current I is equal to beta plus 1 into bracket of IB. VC is equal to VCC minus ICRC minus beta plus 1 into bracket of IBRE. And this is the equation for the collector to emitter voltage for the emitter stabilized bias circuits. But here, there in the common fixed bias configurations, for the fixed bias configurations, the VC is equal to VCC minus ICRC, that is the only equation will be having. It just depends upon the collector current, the collector resistance. But here the VCC minus ICRC minus beta plus 1 into bracket of the IBRE, minus beta plus 1 into bracket of beta plus 1 into bracket of IB to RE. Beta plus 1 into bracket of IB RE, that is the difference. Here also beta plus 1 into bracket of RE, and here also beta plus 1 into bracket of RE. Those are, that is the equation for the collector to emitter voltage. So that if there is any increase in the collector to emitter voltage, that is decreased by beta plus 1 into bracket of RE. And similarly, if there is any increase in the increase in the base current, so that here by using these parameters, beta plus 1 into bracket of RE, beta plus 1 into bracket of the RE, that decreases the increase in the, that decreases the base current. Now we shall consider the one of the numericals for the fixed bias configurations. A base resistance of 240 kilo ohms, collector resistance of 2.2 kilo ohms, and a coupling capacitors at the input and the outputs. Given that supply voltage is 12 volts, RC is equal to 20 kilo, and this capacitor, outer capacitor C2 is equal to 2. Here this coupling capacitors are short circuit, open circuited, base 240, 2.2, and here it is beta. Determine the IBQ, ICQ, VCEQ, VB, VC and VBC. First of all, you have to know about which type of biasing circuit it is. It is a fixed bias circuit because here at the input a base resistance and at the collector resistance RC, so that there will not be any resistance. There will not be any resistance at the base of the there will not be any resistance at the emitter of the transistors. So that IBQ is equal to VCC minus VB upon RB, 47.08 microamperes. ICQ is equal to beta IBQ is equal to 2.35 milliamperes. Okay. Similarly, VCEQ is equal to VCC minus ICRC is equal to 6.83 volts. And VB is equal to VBE is equal to 0.7 volts, because VBE is equal to the VB is equal to VBE plus VE. VB is equal to VB minus VE, since there will not be any resistance in the emitter. Emitter current is equal to 0. Similarly, VC is equal to VCE plus VE. VB is equal to VBE plus VE. So that since VE is equal to 0, VC is equal to collector voltage is equal to minus 7.9 volts. VCE is equal to 6.83 volts. VBC is equal to VB minus VC 0.7 volts minus 6.83 volts is equal to minus 6.13 volts. Is equal to VCE is equal to 6.88 volts.